So now we move on to another cute little fella. And this guy is a stoat. And these guys get confused with weasels and other sorts of creatures, ferrets as well. But they are a little bit different. They are a member of the weasel family, but they're a little bit different to a weasel. They're actually found throughout mainland Britain in a variety of different habitats. A male stoat is called a dog, a hob, or a jack, while a female is called a jill. The collective noun for stoats is either a gang or a pack. Stoats live in territories and occupy multiple dens that are often the home of past prey. And these can be hollows, nests, burrows, or other small sheltered areas. So, for instance, like rabbit warrens or something like that. Stoats are very bold and fearless creatures. They're also very agile, and they are able to climb well. And they are able to also take down young birds in nests. They are also really good swimmers, capable of crossing large rivers. Their primary food source is rabbit, despite being many times its own weight. The number of stoats in the wild is usually linked to rabbit population, but in recent years, their numbers have declined as they are still heavily persecuted by gamekeepers protecting their game birds. Stoats are usually reddish-brown in colour, but stoats that live in the north change their fur colour to white to help blend in with the snowy landscape. And I've actually seen a video of my father-in-law. He was working one day in the countryside and he saw a stoat stalk a rabbit, and he managed to actually get it on film. And you see this stoat kind of working its way around this like outhouse building and actually catch the rabbit like so quick. It's unbelievable. And this rabbit is literally the same size as the stoat and must weigh so much more than that. But they are really, really good hunters. Very, very agile. So, fun fact, the stoat will mesmerize their prey, such as rabbits, by dancing. Sometimes this is called the weasel war dance. So the stoat will dance with the rabbit, and the rabbit will probably think, what the hell is going on? And like stay really, really still, and that's when the stoat strikes. I'll try that one next time. Look at this guy, he's so beautiful. So the stoat is a native species. The males grow 69 centimetres in length, plus the tail at 11 centimetres. Females are 26 centimetres, plus their tail at 9 centimetres. They are about the same size as a small ferret. Their body and neck are cylindrical and long, as we can see here. Very long neck. They have little short legs, brown fur on the back, and creamy white fur on the underparts, and a black tail tip. And like we said, in the north, they change their colour of their fur to white to help blend in with the background. So they live in a wide range of habitats as long as there is suitable food there. This can range from lowland forests to upland moors and even in towns. I've never seen one in the town though. So mating occurs in May and June, followed by a delayed implantation. So the pregnancy doesn't actually happen right away, it's delayed. The births occur in April to May of the next year, producing the females produce one litter, and it's normally 5 to 12 babies. So they nest in grass and leaves, and also in hollow trunks, molehills, walls, banks, or thickets. They have a purely carnivorous diet, including voles, mice, rats, rabbits, hares, and birds. Pre-breeding season, their population is estimated to be 462,000, which is quite a good amount. So that is the stoat.